Hello everyone, welcome to Organolysis. So welcome to the another session of the name reaction series. Now in this video we are going to discuss that the important name reaction, that is called the NEF reaction. Now the NEF reaction is typically called the NEF carbonylation reaction, and this reaction is first observed in the year of 1893, and the scientist that is named by the Konovalov, he first observed that the treatment of potassium salt of 1-phenyl-nitroethane with the dilute acid, that is any kind of H2SO4, they lead to formation and acetophenone derivative. So the important thing that he get first, that the from a nitroalkane he is going to get a carbonyl compound, that is acetophenone. But after 1 year, that is in 1894, the scientist that is NEF first systematically developed the another similar kind of method and the acetic hydrolysis of this of a nitro compound, and he is going to get that the kind of ketone, that is your any kind of carbonyl compound, right? So he first demonstrated the generalization of the how the transformation takes place and how the mechanism of this reaction happening during this course of the reaction. So that is why after that the reaction is named by the NEF reaction. So this reaction is basically from a nitroalkane we are going to get a carbonyl compound. So how to do that? There is a different kinds of procedure is followed. First thing, that if we have a nitroalkane like this that I am written over here, if we treat with a base and with an acid, or after the acetic hydrolysis, you are getting a ketone. And how will you get? I will show you later that how the mechanism of this reaction takes place. And another method is also followed for this reaction, that is your reductive condition. Now reductive condition is basically we are using the titanium trichloride or any CrCl to VCl2 salt, and if we are using this, it will first form the oxime derivative, and after the hydrolysis, acetic hydrolysis, you are getting a ketone product. Now for that you have to know the basic mechanism of this reaction. Now the mechanism of the NEF reaction has been extensively studied for various kind of natural product synthesis, right? So this reaction, first we are going to discuss the NEF reaction under the acidic condition, how this reaction takes place in the acidic condition. So first we have to do the acidic condition mechanism. So this is the acidic method. So when we are using that one, that is, this is your R1 or R2 like this. This is your double bond O. This is your O minus. So this is your nitroalkane that we are starting with this. If we are using a base, so any kind of base, I am not written over there. I am generalized it is B as a base. If we use a base, so if there is an acetic hydrogen, just because it is as adjacent to this nitro group, so that is why it is very much acidic in nature. So it will be obstructed by a base, so that we are getting this one. This is your R1 and R2, and this is your negative charge, right? So after that, this negative charge can in, now we are using the acidic condition. So acidic condition is basically that any kind of H2SO4 or H2SO4 or any acetic acid we can use as a protic acid, right? So in case of protic acid, we can use HCl, H2SO4 or acetic acid, right? So in presence of H plus, so it can go here, and this negative charge can take a proton, so that you are getting this kind of product, that is your OH. Now this is your double bond O, this is a double bond. Now this can go in like this, so this is how you can get a negative charge over here. This is your double bond R1 and R2 like this, okay? So this is basically called the this is your positive charge in all the position, that is the positive charge on the nitrogen center, and this is your nitronic acid. So this is your nitronic acid intermediate. Now after that, this negative charge can take a proton from the source, so it can take a proton like this, so that you are getting this one, double bond R1 and R2. Now after this acidic hydrolysis, that is water is present in the reaction medium, so it can attack over here and it can go like this, so that you are getting this kind of product, right? So this is your OH, this is your R1, this is your R2, and after that this is your OH, right? So next thing which is happening over here is that this bond can go over here and this can leave from the system as this way. So this nitrogen has a lone pair, it can take a proton from acidic medium like this, so that you are getting this one HO, that is your positive center, and R1, and this is your R2, and this is your OH. Now this bond can go here and it can remove from the system like this. So that is basically called hyponitrous acid that you are going to get from this one. So that is what you get, the final product, that is your ketone derivative, that is your desired product, and the side product is that the water and the HNO. Now this HNO is basically called hyponitrous acid. This is your hyponitrous acid, right? So this is all about the acidic condition, and that is the mechanism is using in the acidic condition. Now the next thing is that we have written over here, that is a TICLD, that is your reductive condition. How this reaction takes place in the reductive condition, that you should know, right? So next thing is that the reductive condition. Now when we are using the reductive condition, the same thing is happening over here, that is the we have the R1 and R2, that is the N double bond O, that is your O minus, and this is your positive, like this. Now we are using the TiCl3 in the reductive condition. So this TiCl3, this O minus will directly attack the titanium center and one Cl will leave from the system. So we can write here in this way, that is TiCl2Cl, like this way. So we can write it in this way, so it can attack over titanium center and one Cl will leave from the system. So minus of Cl minus, and you are getting this O TiCl2, that is your double bond O positive, R1 and R2, like this. Now we know that titanium and oxygen generally form a strong bond, so that is why this bond can leave, this will leave from the system as a in this way, that is TiCl2 double bond O. So this moiety will leave from the system, and after that you are getting this one, and that is what it is called, the nitroso compound. So this is your nitroso compound. So this is your nitroso intermediate. Now you have the hydrogen over here. Now it can enolize, or that is basically called the tautomerization. So if it is tautomerizes, then you are getting this one, and that is called your oxime. So it basically goes via the oxime intermediate. Now after this acidic hydrolysis, this will break the imine bond, and you are getting the final desired product, that is your ketone, right? So the next procedure is basically the same like this. So that is what it is, the overall mechanism for the NEF reaction. There is basically two mechanisms, that is acidic condition, another thing is the reductive condition. Now one more thing that you should know, that is the key points for this reaction, and what points you should know for this reaction, that is the nitroalkane. From a nitroalkane you are getting a carbonyl compound. And second thing that you have to keep in your mind, that is the strongly acidic medium. Now why this strongly acidic medium is needed? Now strongly acidic medium means what? That is basically the pH nearly about 1, or pH is nearly, that is less than 1. So if the pH is greater than 1, then what will be the problem for this reaction? Now if the pH is greater than 1, then the simultaneous some byproducts can be formed, that is the oxime or hypo hydroxy nitroso compound can be formed. So that is why pH is basically near about 1. So if the pH is greater than 1, then the problem should be like this, that is the byproduct formation. Now the byproduct means what kind of byproducts is basically formed, that is your oximes or the hydroxy nitroso compound. So these two are the byproducts that can be formed when the pH is greater than 1. So that is why this pH is very much important for the reaction. Now the next thing is the modification. Now the for introduce or to introduce to more chemoselectivity, the modification is needed. Now what kind of modification has been takes place for this reaction? Now the modification is basically that the when we are using the primary nitroalkane, then it can be formed aldehyde or carboxylic acid. But when we are using the secondary nitroalkane, it's basically converted into the ketone. So we can write over here from 2D that is secondary nitroalkane, it basically forms the convert to the ketone, corresponding ketone. And if it is primary, then it will be formed the aldehyde or the carboxylic acid. So this is to the major modification for this reaction. Now what kind of reagent can be used by using different kind of by using not using these two. Now one more thing that is used, basically the reducing agent. So what kind of reducing agent basically used? Reducing is basically used for any zinc or copper, zinc or nickel salt or magnesium powder, that can be used as a reducing agent, right? So this is somewhat the modification of the NEF reaction. Now if you don't want to do this condition, then you can modify your reaction as your choice. That is, you can use your reducing agent or any kind of butyl lithium or like that, that is TMS. So that is what it is, the NEF reaction. Now let's see some examples that you have. We have some examples, that is, you can see over here, that is your nitroalkane given over here. You have the base sodium hydroxide and the acidic condition 3 molar HCl. So you can easily predict what will be the product. You don't need to write the overall mechanism. You can easily predict this selectively, that it will be formed a ketone over here like this. So just you have to identify the nitro group and you have to change it into the corresponding ketone or aldehyde. So that is what you have to need for this reaction. Now similarly, the next thing is given over here, that is a nitrogen NO2 is given, and you have base and the ice cooled KMnO4. Now see, the KMnO4 is basically the oxidizing agent. So you can use, so that is already told over the modification case, that is, you can use any oxidizing agent or reducing agent. So this is basically the same thing. So that can be used for this reaction. So that is the modification of the reaction. Now you are getting this ketone over here, right? So this is all about the examples, and let's come to the previous year question that came in GATE 2014. The question says that you have given a substrate and you have this 2D agent. You have to predict X and Y both. So after forming X, you have given this TiCl. Now from these two, you can easily identify that this is your NEF reaction step. So this is your NEF reaction step. Now what about the first step and what will be the product for this one? Now you can see over here, that is EtoNA and ethanol is given. So you can break in this way, that is Eto minus and Na plus. And you can see over here, there is a two acidic hydrogen, that is either one here or on here. Now this is very much stable just because it is adjacent to the nitro group, and nitro group has a greater electron withdrawing effect. So that is what you get from here. That is NO2, and you have the hydrogen, and Eto minus can take up proton from here, that you get is this one, right? So they are getting from this one to that one. Now this negative charge will attack over here. Now question arises, where it will attack, either in C double bond or in alpha beta center, that is alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Now you can see that this is your soft center, and C double bond O is your hard center, and in this position, that is your alpha beta unsaturated position, is your soft center. So basically soft sub interaction is very much favorable. So that is why it will attack in this position. So this is your alpha beta unsaturated ketone. It can go like this, so that you are getting, that is this one that you are getting, and after that it can take some proton from the ethanol, and you are getting this product as your major one. So this is your NO2. this is NO2, right? So this is all about the X. So this is your product X. Now what about Y? Now the Y step is Y product is here known to you, that is the NEF reaction step, that reductive element, reductive condition that you have given the TiCl3 and water. So what will be the product? This NO2 will convert it to the corresponding ketone, so that you are getting this one as your major product. So this is all about your major product for this reaction, like this, right? So this is your Y. So see that how easy and how important this reaction, that is a NEF carbonylation, and it is basically used for the changing of nitroalkane to the corresponding carbonyl compound, right? So I have covered all this topic related to the NEM reaction, that is the NEF reaction, and I hope this video is very much helpful for you. And if you have any doubt, let me know in the comment section. I will definitely try to answer all those questions, right? So keep sharing my videos in your friend circle as much as you can. And if you like this video, do not forget to subscribe this channel and press the bell icon to get the earlier notification from my channel when I upload videos, right? So that's it for this video, and thank you so much for watching.